U.S. drug maker Moderna says its updated COVID-19 vaccine is effective against a new Omicron variant that has raised fears of a resurgence of infections. The company says its retooled jab was shown to generate a strong human immune response against a BA.2.86. Now, this highly mutated variant carries more than 35 mutations and may be more capable of causing infection in people who had COVID and those vaccinated with previous shots. This particular variant has been reported in the U.S., Britain, South Africa.
The Philippines' dollar reserves slightly down in August. Data from the central bank showed the gross international reserves at $99.8 billion in that month from the flat $100 billion in July. The Banco Central points to government payment of foreign currency debt for the decrease. The BSP also attributes it to the lower value of its gold holdings due to a decrease in the price of gold in the global market. The Commission on Human Rights urges authorities to intensify search efforts for two missing Philippine activists. In a statement, the CHR said the alleged abduction of Janila Castro and Jed Tamano manifests the susceptibility of activists to enforced or involuntary disappearance. It urged the state to take decisive action before a similar incident happens again. The CHR added it has dispatched a quick response operation to probe Castro and Tamano's disappearance. The two were reported missing on September 2. They were doing research on the effects of the Manila Bay reclamation on fishing communities in the province of Bataan. Sources report that Castro and Tamano experienced intimidation and harassment prior to their disappearance.
The Philippine Elections Commission looking to place the town of Libon Albay under red category. Now, this is after a village captain was killed after filing his candidacy for the village and youth council polls in October. COMELEC spokesperson Rex Laudianco says an area is placed under red category if private armed groups are present or if there is a history of election-related violence. Earlier, the COMELEC said it may place a town of Malabang in Lanao del Sur under its control following an incident of election-related violence.
Mahigit 200 pong kapulisan ang idinagdag kasama ng Special Action Force. Ang AFP po ay nag-activate na ng kanilang mga CACUs, pati na rin ng reservists para mag-assist po sa kanilang units sa pagpapanatili po ng security and peace order sa lugar.
Meanwhile, the COMELEC says it has completed the printing of ballots for the October polls. Laudianco says this includes reprinted ballots for villages transferred from Makati to Taguig City. The ballots will be delivered to poll precincts 2 weeks before the elections.
On to more news, more than half of PhilHealth's debt to hospitals is owed to private institutions. That's according to the president of the Private Hospital Association of the Philippines, Dr. Jose De Grano. He said the state health insurer attempted to pay the hospitals back with a debt credit payment system, which De Grano called ineffective. He told Teleradio Servicio he hopes PhilHealth settles its debt soon, as private hospitals have not faltered in their service despite the huge liability.
Tuloy-tuloy naman po ang pagtanggap ng ating mga pribadong ospital. Uh-huh. Yung ginagawa na lang po ng ospital ng ipagpatuloy nila ang kanilang operasyon na hindi naman maapektuhan yung mga kawani o mga staff ng ospital, ay medyo nagda-downsize po sila para na sa ganun po hindi masyado malaki ang ano nila at ipagpatuloy ang kanilang operasyon.
PhilHealth spokesperson Dr. Israel Francis Parga said they hope to pay off at least 80% or 20 billion pesos of the debt. Pargas noted delays in the settlements are mostly due to processing issues.
Ang PhilHealth ay hindi rin basta nagbabayad dahil tayo nga po ay una, ito'y pera ng nating mga miyembro. Pangalawa, ay tayo po ay kinukuha rin. So hindi rin po tayo kaagad-agad nagbabayad at since meron po mga evaluation na kailangan, may mga requirements. So medyo nagtatagal po doon ang ating pagpoproseso.
The Philippine House Minority Leader chides the Public Works Department for the continued flooding in the country despite huge spending on flood control projects. RG Cruz on the line with the details. RG?
Yes, Ron, the Philippine government has spent almost 2 trillion pesos since 2016 for flood control projects, yet the country continues to suffer from flooding. A minority lawmaker observed during the budget briefing of the Department of Public Works and Highways for 2024 at the House Appropriations Committee. House Deputy Minority Leader at Regents Representative Franz Castro noted that the amount is exclusive of spending on foreign assisted projects and flood control, even as flood control is supposed to get additional funds worth over $257 billion in 2024. The DPWH Secretary, Emmanuel Bonoan, however, explained that flood control is not a matter of engineering interventions alone, as he pointed out that the DPWH only handles engineering solutions. Castro, however, noted that even areas that were not flooded in the past have begun to suffer from flooding. The DPWH chief noted that the anti-flood control measures and that the anti-flood measures have become the concern of the president. Still, the law maintained that the government cannot do without dissenting or dredging. Ron?
RG Cruz with that story. Thanks, RG.
An administration senator voices concern over civilian agencies seeking confidential or intelligence funds. Senate Deputy Majority Leader J.V. Ejercito asserts it seems to be a growing trend among government offices. Ejercito believes departments not involved in security or gathering information have no business seeking these funds.
Mukhang nauuso na. No, even civilian departments and other agencies are now, lahat sila, meron na silang confidential and intelligence fund.
Mm-hmm.
But me personally, dapat i-concentrate natin yan dun sa mga usual agencies. Parang last year kasi dumami na yung nagre-request ng, lalo ngayon dumami na yung nagre-request ng Intel funds.
Dahil iba meron.
So parang nag-ano lang eh.
Gaya-gaya, sir.
Hawa-hawa lang.